We're learning more about the first Utahn killed in the war in Israel. The close to 24-year-old Lotan Abir says that he was shot and killed while spending time with friends.
New special Shelby Lofton shows us how members of this tight-knit community here will remember him.
Tonight, more than 150 people showed up here at the Salt Lake City Synagogue to stand in support of Israel amidst the ongoing war there. It's the same day we've learned about the first Utahn who was killed in that war.
And the whole room would brighten up just by his smile.
24-year-old Lotan Abir was beginning to find out who he wanted to be and what he wanted to do.
And he was just at a stage in his life where he was beginning to rediscover his Jewishness. And he was very excited about it.
Rabbi Benny Zippel was one of his biggest spiritual mentors.
So here in Utah, we have very frequently groups of young men and women coming from Israel after they have completed their army duty.
Rabbi Zippel said Abir came to Salt Lake City to explore life outside of what he had always known. He said the young man dabbled in locksmith and handyman work.
Coming here to a place like Utah, which is obviously not predominantly Jewish, as Israel is, he felt somewhat challenged, and it actually had a very good influence on him.
He'd gone back to Israel for the Jewish holidays when he was caught in the surprise attack.
They had gone to that rave that took place on Saturday night.
And Rabbi Zippel said Abir and his friends ran when they heard gunshots.
The next day, Sunday, his family received formal notice that his body was found.
Now, when Rabbi Zippel and other Jewish men and women walk into Chabad Lubavitch of Utah, they remember Abir.
Every time he came in and out of his building, he always with a pledge, Rabbi Benny, I'll be back. I'll be back soon and again. And it really has left a vacuum in my heart.
Rabbi Zippel said he's encouraging everyone who knew Lotan Abir or who wants to honor his memory to commit to one mitzvah or one good deed. We'll have more information on how you can honor his memory on our website, kslTV.com. In Salt Lake City, Shelby Lofton, KSL 5 News.
Thank you.